Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
So hello everyone, hello students. Let's move further into this chapter and see what the concept of work done by a reciprocating pump. So we've seen the different parts of a pump, we've seen the working principle, we've seen the single acting and the double acting. Let's move on to the work done by the pump. So the topic of work done by reciprocating pumps is a pretty simple one. For that, you should know how much water is getting discharged every stroke. So if you want to know how much water is being delivered out in each stroke, so there is one formula for it. You can calculate how much water is being discharged. So the volume of water that is discharged is nothing but the cross-sectional area of the piston into the length through which it is displacing. So that is, we call it as swept volume. So that is the amount of volume that is getting discharged in one stroke. So volume of liquid that is getting discharged per stroke is nothing but cross-section area into length. Now this is the volume that we get in per stroke. So you should know how much strokes take place per second. So for that you should know the RPM of the crank. So suppose the RPM of the crank is given as N, and RPM is revolutions per minute, and that revolutions per minute is nothing but number of strokes per minute. So you know the volume that is getting delivered per stroke, and you also know how much strokes are taking per minute. So if you multiply it with this term volume of liquid per stroke with number of strokes per second, you'll get the term called as volume of liquid per second. So N is the RPM, which is nothing but strokes per minute. So N by 60 will give you strokes per second. So this is nothing but the volume of liquid that will be delivered per second. So A L N by 60, where A is the cross section area of the piston, L is the length, the stroke length you call it, N is the RPM. So this will give you the volume that will be delivered per second. But what we are interested in is work done. So for work done is nothing but the weight of water and through what distance it is displaced. Because you know that work is nothing but force into displacement. Force is equivalent to weight. So you should know the weight of water that is being displayed through certain distance. So we know volume per second. Now let's get the value of weight of water from this. The amount of water, that is the weight of water from this term. Since we know that density is mass upon volume, and so mass will be volume into density, so weight will be mass into gravity. So weight is nothing but density into volume into gravity. So we know the discharge Q ALN by 60, so rho G ALN by 60 will give you the weight of the water that is discharged per second. So this is nothing but the weight of water discharged per second. Now you know the weight, now you have to calculate the work done. So it's very simple, the weight of water discharged per second into the distance through which it has to be moved. Now the distance through which it has to be lifted is nothing but HS plus HD. We saw earlier the reservoir is at a certain level, then HS is nothing but the distance from the reservoir to the center of the pump, and HD is nothing but the center of the pump to the outlet of the delivery pipe. So the water has to be lifted through a distance of HS plus HD. So that is the distance. So this is the formula of work done that we get in reciprocating pumps. So we've derived this formula. This can be used as a formula for calculations and numericals, the work done by reciprocating pump. It's pretty simple. You have to get the weight of water discharged per second, then you have to see how much is the distance through which it has to be pumped. Now you got the weight, then you multiply it with distance, you get the work done. So that's how simple it is. I hope you've understood it. It's a very simple topic. So thank you.